Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching Today I Found Out, and in the video today, peanuts, peeing on the side of a bus, and planting trees, the rather strange traditions of going to space. Although you'd expect people tasked with going to space to be a fairly rational lot, astronauts and cosmonauts are noted as being an exceptionally superstitious group, many of whom conform to a number of seemingly arbitrary and often unusual rituals before each flight. While there is a perfectly reasonable explanation for most, if not all, of these traditions and customs, usually dating back to the early days of the space race, many of them can seem quite peculiar without any context. For example, every time the workers at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, usually abbreviated to JPL, launch a probe or satellite, they will eat peanuts. This is a tradition that started in 1964 after the successful launch of Ranger 7, a spacecraft designed to take pictures of the moon. Prior to the Ranger 7, unsurprisingly, there were Rangers 1 through 6, all of which failed at their missions for various reasons. However, on the day they launched the Ranger 7, a random engineer brought some peanuts into the control room as a snack, and he shared them around. The launch was successful, and as a result of this, it has been a tradition amongst JPL staff ever since to snack on peanuts in the control room for good luck. When it comes to these superstitions, there are likely very few people working for NASA who truly believe that bad luck will befall them or their mission if they fail to shovel handfuls of peanuts into their mouths immediately after launch. It's just a nice way of acknowledging the work of those before them and fostering camaraderie between staff. However, there are some traditions that people take deathly seriously. For example, in Russia, no launch is ever permitted to be scheduled on October the 24th. Why is this? Well, not one, but two missiles set to be launched on this date in 1960 and 1963 exploded before launch, killing 92 people in 1960 and 7 in 1963. Also, before any cosmonaut is allowed to go to space, they must travel to the Kremlin and pay their respects to Yuri Gagarin, Sergei Korolev, a famed Soviet rocket engineer, Vladimir Komarov, the first known man killed during a space mission, and the three cosmonauts who perished during the Soyuz 11 mission. These men's ashes are actually buried within the walls of the Kremlin. Anyone wishing to fly to space via a Russian rocket is expected to honor this tradition, regardless of their nationality. Other traditions expected to be adhered to include a walk along the Avenue of Heroes, a name given to a path flanked by two rows of trees located at the Baikonur Cosmodrome. Shortly before their own mission, astronauts and cosmonauts alike are expected to plant their own sapling along this avenue to continue the tradition. The origins of this custom, like many in Russian space travel, are attributed to Gagarin, who did the same thing before his flight in 1961. As a result, Gagarin's tree is, unsurprisingly, the oldest. Perhaps the most unusual and famous custom attributed to Gagarin, though, is the one that involves urinating all over the bus that takes you to the Baikonur Cosmodrome. More specifically, it's tradition to urinate over the right rear wheel. Gagarin is said to have done this shortly before climbing into the Vostok 1 capsule, as he really needed to pee and couldn't do so in his spacesuit. To honor Gagarin, it has been customary ever since for cosmonauts and also visiting astronauts to do this as well. Female cosmonauts and astronauts are excused from this particular tradition if they so choose, though some have been known to bring a vial of their urine along with them so that they can take part. Funnily enough, there's actually been some debate about whether Gagarin actually did stop the bus to do this pee prior to launch, as the only evidence to say he did is anecdotal in nature, but this hasn't stopped people doing it later anyway. Another cosmonaut tradition, not necessarily inspired by Gagarin, but still linked to him in some way, is a visit to his office, which hasn't been altered since the day he died. While loitering in his office, cosmonauts will sign his guestbook, and if several persistent rumors are to be believed, some ask his ghost for permission to fly to space. Immediately before the launch, Russian cosmonauts will also be played a selection of Soviet-era love songs as a final tribute to Gagarin, who, shortly before the launch of Vostok 1, requested some music to lighten the mood and was simply played a selection of love songs. Out of respect for everyone's comfort, the individual crew of each particular flight is free to pick out their selection of own music to play, leading to quite an eclectic playlist for launches with an international crew. Other traditions that are generally observed prior to cosmonauts' flight into space include a viewing of the Soviet-era movie White Son of the Desert, a custom started in the late 1960s when this was apparently the only movie available to cosmonauts for a few years, and they also signed their name on a hotel door. As cosmonauts leave the hotel, they will traditionally do so listening to the song Trava Udoma by the band Zemel Yane. The song's title roughly translates to grass by the home. As if this wasn't all enough, a final ritual that is commonly upheld is the attaching of a small talisman to the command console, just in front of the onboard camera. The idea behind this is that when the craft finally reaches orbit, the talisman, which is attached by a small length of string, will begin to float around, giving the ground crew visual confirmation that the launch was a success. And now for some bonus facts. Russian ground crews similarly have a number of traditions they like to uphold before each mission, the most famous of which is putting coins on the track used to take the capsule to the launch pad. Cosmonauts are forbidden from taking part as it's believed to be bad luck for them to see the capsule arriving. Instead, this day is the traditional day which they will get a haircut. And now for another bonus fact. Gagarin was also noted as being incredibly charming and likable, with many commenting on his magnetic personality and attention-grabbing smile. Gagarin was also so likable that in an anonymous survey of the 20 men being considered for the Vostok 1 mission, in which candidates were asked to say who they felt should go to space if they weren't chosen, only 3 candidates chose someone other than Gagarin. And now for another bonus fact. Gagarin had a small scar on his face, caused by a fall from a second-story window. So how did he get this? Well, he jumped. You see, while Yuri was at a resort at the Black Sea, at one point he was spending a little time with a nurse called Anna in his room when his wife arrived. Rather than face the music, Yuri tried escaping out of the window. According to an eyewitness of the leap, he hit a curbstone with his forehead. It was not a good landing. As well as having an unhappy wife on his hands, he was left with a scar above his eyebrow. And now for another bonus fact. Although American astronauts are notably less superstitious than their Russian peers, one particularly popular ritual is a breakfast of filet mignon and eggs before a mission. This custom was started by astronaut Alan Shepard back in 1961 when he ate the same breakfast prior to the Freedom 7 mission, which was such a success most astronauts have since eaten the same breakfast. Although it should be noted here that some have little appetite for food on launch day and abstain from doing this. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below and don't forget to subscribe. We've got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. Also, I'd like to take this minute to thank our patrons on Patreon. If you're interested in supporting us with a small financial contribution every month to help us keep making these daily videos, please do head over to the link in the description below. And as always, thank you for watching.